Hi team, thank you for watching this video. So hope you all know that we are doing the Azure YouTube series. So here, so the last session we were in that discussion of our virtual machines. Okay, so how we are taking images backup or how we are taking the snapshot now. So from the continuation in today's session that we are going to be seeing the new service, which is something called Azure Storage Account. So Azure Storage Account. So what is meant by Azure Storage Account here? So why we are using the Azure Storage Account here? That is what we are going to be discuss. So the storage account that provides a unique namespace for your Azure storage data that is accessible from anywhere in the world. So over it may be HTTP or it may be HTTPS. So now the data in your Azure storage account is a durable and highly available and secure and massively scalable. So you know, it's all the places, right? Your data will be always highly available. Anytime we can go, anytime we can take it something way. So always it is secure because while transferring the data in the public, right, we may facing the issues, the like intruders or some viruses, something. Okay, so an Azure account contains all of your Azure storage data objects, blobs, files, queues, tables, and disks. So in the disks, no, that we already seen in the topic of our VM. So there we were additionally added few disks and further things. So in the Azure storage account, right, we have some types. Okay, so types of storage account, or we can say types of disk or storage, types of storage account types, we can say. Okay, there is a general purpose V2 and general purpose V1 and block storage and file storage and block storage we have. So here the each and every storage account types all provided some supported service that they're having some redundancy option. Also they have some deployment model also. Okay, so the resource manager and the classic something, it shows the deployment. Like in early days we were using the classic portal, and right now we were using the resource manager portal. In that way, general purpose V2 supported services for blob, file, queue, table, and disk, and the data lag generation to square. And then redundancy option going to be LRS, GRS, REAGRS, ZRS, ZGRS, RJ, ZGRS something. Okay, so what is the LRS in the sense, like, you know, right? So local redundancy service, okay, and then geo redundancy service, and then read access geo redundancy service, and then zone redundant service. So like that we were having. The same way when you're coming for a general purpose V1, the blob, file, queue, table, disk. So these are the supported service I'm having. And redundancy type acts as usual, the LRS and GRS, REGRS. So the deployment model we can use in the both portals, like a resource manager as well as a classic. So now blob storage, which is something, a blob, block, blob, and the append blobs only. So here only redundancy in all LRS and ZRS. So local redundancy and then zone redundancy. It can be used only in the resource manager. And then file storage we having, it is supporting only file and the local redundancy storage and the geo zone redundancy storage, that is what we were having. And it is also working in the resource manager only. Blob storage, so blob, it will be supporting the blob. And then LRS, GRS, REGRS will be the redundancy option and can be done only in the resource manager. So in the overall five kind of storage type account, so only the person general purpose V1 can be working in the both resources portal. One is resource manager, another is a classic manager. So in the types of storage account, how I can able to create the storage account here? So I just want to log in into the portal. So in the portal, right, we may aware of it. There is a storage account, the concept name called, the service name called a storage account. So like how the Docker, how the Kubernetes having some containers, the same way here, one account we are going to be at the name called a storage account here. So the storage account can be stored up to a 100 TB or 500 TB of data in the cloud. So here, let it load. And I'm just going to be creating a storage account. I just want to go for one new resource group, the resource group one created, and storage account name going to be. So HT U2. HTU2 that we can take. So HTU2, and then region, which region that you want to create your central US, I'm just giving. Let me going with the performance in the standard one or premium one. So when you're going for standard one, it's a recommended for most scenarios of general purpose VM. When you're going per premium, recommend for the scenario, the required low latency. So when you're seeing here the performance, determine whether you want to have premium performance for block blobs or file share, and then your page blobs in your storage account. So if you need that much of access, that you need to have select a premium account only. Then I comes to come the page blobs and file share and file share block blobs like that. If you're going for standard, recommended for most scenarios, like what kind of redundancy we are giving, whether local redundancy, a geo zone redundancy, or geo zone storage redundancy, and then so geo redundant storage like that we're giving. And next advanced, and here we are going to be enable secure transfer, enable infrastructure encryption, and enable block public access, enable storage account key access. So based on my wish, I'm just going to be providing the security, and then we'll be coming to the direct one, what is the TLS version and what is the data lag storage generation, and whether the block storage will be accepting or not, whether access share what it is, whether hot or cool. Frequently, if you are accessing your data, frequently you are accessing your bucket, in the sense there we can go for a hot. If suppose normally we are connecting or normally we are getting the data, in the sense we'll be going with the cool here. And then enable large file share. If you want to go for a large file share, you can enable it here. Either while configuring the file share, you can able to do that activity. And then tables and queues, as usual, based on my recommend, I can go. And the networking connectivity method it is asking. So connectivity comes under public endpoint. So public endpoint, when I'm giving, it is allowing us on the data. And then public endpoint selected networks, in the sense allowing in the selected networks. And then finally, a private endpoint going to be restrict from others. Restrict the data for all others. Okay. And then we'll be going with the public endpoint only. So routing going to be Microsoft network routing, because the easiest part that can be fine over that. Data production, tags, and finally we are reviewing and creating our storage account. This is the part that we are going to be useful only creating a storage account. So only creating a storage account. So basic and advanced. So basic details, I got a free trial, and then resource group, central US, and a high-tech HDU2, the storage account name. So like that, the n number of minimum characteristics and the n number of normal specification will be available here. So once it done, we'll be going with the review and then creating the resources here. We're just going to be creating our resources. Your resource got initializing here. In the notification panel, I can able to see that what is the right now resources condition like that. So fine. So once the storage account got created, what we are going to be doing, in the sense that we can able to create the disk, we can able to create the file storage, or we can able to create the block storage, and then we can create the table, and then we can create the queues also. In that scenario, we can able to see the deployment is in the progress or not. So once the deployment got in the progress, what we can do, in the sense immediately able to open the particular resources. There I able to see what are the possibility that I can make it over there. So meanwhile, so this is a storage account. Under the storage account, disk we were already seeing in the VM session. So the disks, right, will be attached and can be removed. That's under the executable disks that we can see. Executable disk. So remaining that other things, right, like normally you're storing a data only. So here your data got created. Let me go into the resources. HDU2 is the storage account name. So inside the storage account, we can having the containers, file share, queues, and tables, et cetera. And then, so here you can see your storage account details. So this is the storage account that is how I'm just creating. So when we are coming to the containers under file share, queues, table, that I can able to automatically get it able. I can able to get the same. So under the overview, let me come down. Let me scroll down here. Once the scrolling down happening, so here I can able to see. So file share, queue services, and the table services, something like. Okay, the file share is something. Enabled and disabled concept will be done. So file share, if you want, we can able to create the file share. So container, the block storage, if you want, you can able to create the block storage here. Okay, so thank you guys. So we can see in the next video. So hopefully we are going to be seeing in the next video with another topic. So under the storage account, right, we are going to be see the file storage as well as the block storage also. So thank you for watching video.